Jolin has very generously allowed us to give away.
Of course, must support you, ma.
Oh, right. Yeah. If you don't give away, nobody will watch my video, right?
No, la.
Hello, today I'm with Jolin and we are going to talk about DIY leathercraft. Hello Jolin!
Hi!
Yeah, you want to tell us about your leathercraft?
Okay, so of course the most important thing in leathercrafting is of course the materials, and we cannot do leathercrafting without leather, right? So actually I brought 3 pieces of scrap leather from my leftover, you know, leftover project. So what I have here, it's called chevre. This is actually what Hermes typically uses. Yeah, Hermes. So it's actually very sought after, and because Hermes uses it, right? So a lot of leather crafters, they actually use chevre, you know, for their projects. It's quite, you know, it's soft.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's actually soft.
Yeah, it's the kind of leather.
It's very supple. It's very supple. So it's very soft. It's available in many colors as well. Mm. Yeah. Okay, so besides leather, then of course we have what you call pricking irons.
Pricking irons.
Pricking irons, or there's another name for it. It's called chisels. Mm. So what we do is, you know, of course we can actually see over here, right? They are like stitches over here. So when we glue 2 pieces of leather together, and then we need to stitch, right? So we will need to like punch holes, and then we have this. I call it a scratcher.
Scratcher.
So basically, like, you know, you have templates like this, for example, right? So this is actually a card holder. So what you can do is you can draw, you can like measure, you know, the dimensions accordingly, and then you draw on a piece of card paper, and then what you do is you know, you place the template and then you just like scratch. Then so once you make the mark already, right, then you can just go ahead and cut it.
So for fabric, usually you use chalk. But for leather, you use a scratcher.
Scratcher, because the tip is so fine, so there is actually a lesser margin for error in terms of the dimension wise. Yeah. So next, of course, we have, okay, what I have here is 2 different kind of blades. That's what I typically use to cut leather. Of course, the easy way is to actually use a pair of scissors, but of course, the scissors will not give a very clean edge, a very clean cut. Okay. So, yep. So these are the 2 cutters, and this is a hole puncher. You know, we use this to punch holes in, you know, in leather belts and whatnot, yeah. Okay, and then we have, of course, a cutting mat, right? And then we will need metal ruler. Okay, metal ruler is because when we scratch, you know, the template, the shape from the leather, right? So what you need to do is actually you need that ruler to guide the penknife along.
Right.
Yeah. And over here, something very cute. Can you guess like what is this?
Eyelet.
Yeah, it's actually, it's called a Chicago screw. Okay. So you can actually like look at, like for example, like, you know, this piece of leather, this piece of clutch, I would say. So you actually like, you know, Chicago screw.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
This is actually like something very leather craft that you'll use this kind. Is other kind of like art you wouldn't really use or material?
For this, you mean Chicago screw? Not that I can think of. Yeah, so far I've only used this for leather crafting.
True.
Yeah.
Okay, so Jolin, today you are going to show us how to make something simple.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm just gonna teach something very simple, which anyone who has never done
leather,
really, anyone can do.
Right.
So okay, so what we have here is a card holder.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is so simple because it doesn't require any stitching. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. If we were to do stitching today, I think this whole video is gonna take like 4 hours. Yes.
Time lapse.
Yeah. So what we have here, this is a different kind of card holder as well. It's just different design. Just different design. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, okay, just to give mention, this template is from Make Supply.
Make Supply. Yes. Yeah. So you can actually download templates online. You can actually find free templates online, or maybe you can think of like whatever design that you want. Then you think of how it's being made, and then you draw on like cut paper. Cut it out, and then this would be your template. It's so much easier. Yeah, okay. I have this piece of green leather. Okay, so what I do is I'll flip the leather to its flesh side.
Okay.
Right, so I'll place the template here, and then I have this scratchy thing. Okay, so what I'll do is I will trace. Okay, so we scratch throughout.
Right.
Okay, actually there's another alternative, like if you don't want to use a scratcher, right, you can actually use a pen.
Right.
Yeah. They are that kind of
erasable pen.
Yes. That actually leather crafter uses a lot. Yeah, I think you can actually remove it using water. So I think it's a water soluble. So now that's the cutting part. So some people actually prefer to use the typical pen knife, and then some people prefer to use the roller blade. Yeah. So I would
like
prefer
the pizza cutter.
So I actually prefer to use kind of roller blade for thinner leather.
Right.
Yeah, because if you exert like too much pressure onto the leather, right, the leather will just like run, and leather is stretchable as well. So when you cut like thinner pieces of leather, or rather like stretchable leather, I should prefer to use the roller cutter.
Okay.
So of course for today, you know, we can just try out with the normal.
The more accessible tool.
Correct. So you just place the ruler against the line, and then you cut. Okay, what I'll do, right, is to make it easier, cut the leather smaller. So it's easier to
maneuver.
Yep. Right. And then you can actually save all your scraps, you know, in case you can use them to make like smaller items.
Yeah,
never waste them because leather is not cheap.
Yeah.
Okay, if
so for roller cutter, you don't need the ruler.
You can use the ruler as well, but unless
you're pro like
practice.
No,
if you practice enough, Okay. Alright, so now we have the shape, right? Okay, so you can actually see that such templates, right, they have instructions, like over here. So these are the areas where you have to punch the holes through, and these are the fold lines. So what you can do is, after you cut out the piece ready of leather, right, so what you can do is actually you place on top of it again,
right?
Then you start like marking out using a scratcher, okay. Mark out where the holes should be.
Right.
Okay. So this is the fold line, so you can just go ahead and fold it first. Okay, so it's supposed to look like this, right? It's supposed to look, yep. So we can grab the hole puncher. Okay, so just now we actually made like markings, right? Okay, so what we can do is we can go ahead and punch a hole. Right, you can see there's a hole now. Then, using the Chicago screw, you just screw it open. Okay. And then you just put through.
Right.
Yeah. So this is the finished product. So anyway, if let's say you are unhappy with, you know, the edges, you know, if you think that it's it looks quite unfinished, or if the lines are not cut nicely, what you can do is you can actually take a piece of like a file,
okay.
And what you can do is you just file it up.
This file is for fingernails one, right?
Yeah, for fingernails, yes. Oh, okay. Yeah, correct. No more. So you can actually use this. I prefer to use this kind of like file for nails. Otherwise, you can also use like a normal sandpaper.
Mm.
Yeah, but I think I prefer this because it has more structure. So okay. It's actually easier to move the file.
Mm.
Yeah, it's easier to file. I mean, it's just a personal preference, you know, like whatever works for you, you know, just go ahead and use whatever tools you want. Yes. Mm. Mm, correct. I think leather crafting can really test, like, I mean, can really train a person's like patience. Don't you think so?
Yeah. We have three card holder that we made, and Jolin has very generously allowed us to give away.
Of course, must support you, ma.
Oh,
right.
Yeah. If you don't give away, nobody will watch my video, right?
No, lah. No.
Okay, so we are going to give away this wallets. No, not wallet. Card holders.
Card holders, yeah.
And more details will be given if you follow my Instagram, Facebook, and also YouTube. So look out for it.